me, Sam.
No.
Taylor, stop. It's all right. Be afraid.
You cannot be here. Why are you here? Why, Sam? Why? Dad misses you. So do I.
It's okay. I'm right here.
Is there a point to any of this?
A point?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Come on. You're talking about dreams here.
I know. I'm trying to explain.
Let me explain something to you. As fascinating and, well, maybe relevant as it is, the fact that you had some scary dream last month. We are dealing with the real-life homicide here. So I would appreciate it if you would indulge me and just stick to the facts. And stop playing these stupid little games, all right?
I'm not playing games. I'm not playing games. I don't have to be here, you know? I know my rights.
I got a dead college kid downstairs who's got twice as many rights as you. And I need some answers, and I need them now.
Tell it your way, then. Why is this dream so important?
I'd had it before. Maybe a dozen times in the past 4 years. It was at my father's house. It's only a few miles from campus. So I stay there sometimes when he's in town. It was the anniversary of Sam's death.
Sam was your brother? He killed himself 4 years ago. You found the body. What were you, a senior in high school?
Junior.
So if you've had this dream a dozen times before, why was that night so important?
Because he never took his hood off before. I'd forgotten how terrible it was when I found him. My dad and I had never really discussed it before then. Dad? Do you remember the last thing you and Sam talked about? I mean, did he say anything? I know he was worried. He wanted you to be proud of him.
I was proud of him. He was my son.
The last thing we talked about was you. About that watch you wear.
Taylor.
You wanted him to be a skull so badly.
Taylor, this is inappropriate. I only wanted him to experience the same things I had.
When he didn't make it through the initiation, he thought he'd failed you.
He was a legacy. If he just tried a little harder.
He did try, Dad.
But I'm a legacy too. Aren't I?
Taylor, you know what I meant. I never loved you any less, you know that.
I do know that. I do. But it was always different with us. Wasn't it?
I'm sorry if it seemed that way.
I just wish you could be the same father to me that you were to him.
I want to be.
Look. I know you're flying back to Washington tomorrow night. But I've got a swim meet in the afternoon. If you're interested.
Congratulations.
Glad somebody cared enough to show up.
I wouldn't miss it. Unless, of course, you started losing. I couldn't be seen hanging out with a loser, right?
Oh, mm-hmm. Lucky I'm on a winning streak, then.
I know I'm lucky. Mr. Rawlings. Roger. I mean, Mr. Roy.
Roger's fine. Do you have a moment?
Absolutely. I'll be right back, okay?
Right. Don't let me get in the way.
Come on, Taylor. He's a skull. They make their selections this week. You know how big this is.
Oh, yes. I know. Roger, I'm wondering, how many women are you planning on tapping?
Excuse me?
I'm serious. 200 meter free. Are the Skulls actually going to pick the best candidates this year, or are you going to go with the same old batch of spoiled rich boys?
I wouldn't know anything about it. Although, from what I understand, that particular organization would really be none of your concern.
I'm just saying, it is the 21st century. Maybe it's time you step into it. Because I'd certainly like to be considered.
Like I said, I have no idea what you're talking about. Well, perhaps we can finish this conversation some other time.
Wait a minute. This is the first time you met Roger Lloyd?
It was the first time I talked to him. I'd seen him before. Class, on campus.
And you didn't like him?
I didn't know him.
So you just decided to get into a confrontation with a guy you didn't know in front of your boyfriend?
It was not a confrontation.
But you were upset that Roger and Ethan had excluded you.
I was upset that Ethan was so desperate to impress Roger.
So he'd get picked for the Skulls?
Yes. But he thought I'd screwed things up for him.
What the hell was that about?
Just letting him know that I'm interested in becoming a member.
Well, how about letting me know first? Are you trying to ruin this for me?
No, Ethan. Maybe I'm trying to do something for myself. Maybe I'm tired of being treated like a second-class citizen just because I'm a woman.
What are you talking about? The Skulls do not accept women. End of story. Join a sorority if that's what you want.
Oh, gee. Why didn't I think of that?
You cannot be serious about this.
I thought you, of all people, would want to support me.
I do support you in everything. But there's no way in hell you're gonna get tapped by the Skulls. So I don't know why we're talking about this. Drivers
ready? Neither do I. I got a paper to write.
Take your mark.
See you later.
I thought we agreed we were gonna cut back on the whole, you know, throwing wet bags around thing. So, do we have to play, like, 20 questions, or can we skip right to the part where you tell me what's wrong?
What else, Ben?
I knew it. Well, sounds like a cookie dough moment. Oh, bowls are straight from the container.
So, you think I should join a sorority?
Well, I just think it would be so much fun if you pledged for me. What? Well, come on. I'm this year's pledge chair. We could have so much fun, and I would totally take it easy on you with the whole initiation thing.
I'm sorry, but it's not the same. Sororities are all about having fun while you're in school, and that's fine. I just don't have time for that. The skulls are more about what you do once you get out of here.
The skulls? Mm-hmm. You're not serious.
Why does everybody say that?
Because it's true. And why on earth would you even want to?
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't envious of what they represent. The money, the power. If it weren't for them, my father never would.
No way. Your dad's a skull?
Veronica, I did not say that. You did not hear me say that. Really, this isn't something you can talk about.
So, you're saying they got him elected to Congress?
It didn't hurt. Mm-hmm. It's not just about that. It's about the way he sees me. I wanted it so badly for my brother. I mean, anyway, I thought if I could make it happen for me, if there was any way I could become a Skull, maybe it'd help him get over Sam. Maybe he'd finally see me as more than just his fragile daughter.
Unless you plan on growing a penis, you're not getting in.
It's just so wrong that they can get away with that.
There ought to be a law.
You know what? You're right.
Sorry to bother you, but I'd like to file a discrimination complaint against a campus organization.
That's a serious charge, Ms.
Brooks. Taylor Brooks.
Your father is Congressman Martin Brooks?
Yes, sir.
Then I'll trust you have a legitimate grievance.
Yes, sir, I do. This particular group has been allowed to operate on campus for far too long without being held accountable for its gender-biased policies. They're about to select new members, and I'd like to challenge that selection process.
And who did you say this group is?
The Skulls.
At this point, I'm hoping this is a joke.
No, sir, it's not. I've written down my arguments.
Come to my office at noon tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Hey, you mind if I join you?
Not exactly dressed for it.
Yeah, I know. Can we stop?
I just had a water break.
How about an apology break?
Okay, Bill, you're up first. Let's see it.
Look, Taylor, the other day with Roger, I was a jerk. I'm sorry.
Well, I appreciate the apology, but I'm not gonna just pretend like it didn't happen.
Plan on doing a lot of groveling.
I filed a complaint with the dean.
You did what?
Yeah.
You're gonna try and force him to tap you.
Or other equally qualified women.
Equal. I can't believe I'm hearing this.
Forgot about that apology pretty quickly.
Okay, look, I know that you have this thing with your dad and you want to prove something to him. That's fine. Why does it have to be this?
Why shouldn't it be this?
Because you're going to mess it up for other people.
You mean you?
Yes. I mean me. Look, Taylor, Roger Lloyd all but promised me a spot. If you piss him off, I can forget about it.
I'm meeting with the dean at noon tomorrow. I'll call you. Let you know how it goes.
This is bullshit.
Let go of me.
Look.
Let go of my arm, Ethan. I'm not doing this to hurt you. But I'm not gonna back down. I'm sorry.
Miss Brooks, have a seat.
Thank you.
Why don't we get right down to it? You have the floor.
As of last year, every other male-only society on campus had opened its doors to women. I think it's time the Skulls do the same.
But if the Skulls were like every other society, we wouldn't be here, would we? After all, isn't it our very uniqueness that makes membership so valuable?
Yes. Yes, it is, but our uniqueness. Then why have this meeting? Why even waste your time?
Because I'm interested in what you have to say. Your statement claims that we are in violation of federal law. But since we neither receive funding from the university nor utilize its facilities, what compels us to obey its rules?
Actually, an argument could be made that the Skulls' headquarters is a campus facility, and therefore the organization must comply with all gender equality legislation.
The tomb is built by the Skulls and is maintained by the Skulls, entirely at our own expense.
That may be. But as these documents show, the tomb is built on university property. The land was leased to the Skulls in 1793 for the sum of $1 per year. The lease was prepaid for 250 years, which means that the land belongs to the school until the year 2043.
Fine, we'll buy the land.
The lease is binding. It cannot be broken, not even for a sale. That building is on school property. Any organization using it and any activities taking place within it must be open to both men and women.
This can't be legitimate.
Well played, Miss Brooks. Your time in the library paid off. I warned the council.
that you might find this. I also told them, if you did, I would have no choice but to extend my hand and grant your wish.
What? You can't do this.
The decision has already been made. Miss Brooks will be tapped. After all, she is a legacy.
Thank you.
Hey! Word to the wise, Miss Brooks. You should savor this little moment of victory, because your life's about to become a living hell. As long as I'm around, you'll never become a skull.
Now that's an interesting offer.
Are you saying you threatened him?
It was a comeback. It didn't mean anything.
Really?
What do you want me to do? Lie and pretend that Roger was my friend? I'm telling you the truth. I want this solved as much as you do.
Then why don't you give us something we can use, huh?
I'm trying to.
Well, then try a little harder, Ms. Brooks. What does this club have to do with this murder?
Everything.
So this was about 3 weeks ago, right? What happened next?
I felt badly that Ethan wasn't selected. I knew he was angry, but I wanted to see if our relationship was worth salvaging.
I didn't know that you could cook.
A girl has other means.
Looks delicious. You didn't have to do all this.
Just wanted a chance for us to spend some time together. Alone.
I thought we were losing this.
I think we need to figure out where we stand, but I don't want to lose this. I don't want to lose us. Okay, I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Mr. Lloyd.
Miss Brooks, your attendance is requested at the tomb. Is this a problem for you?
No.
Taylor, what's going on? Hey, Roger.
Ethan. Well, Miss Brooks?
Ethan.
Yeah, sure.
I do apologize, Ethan. After all, I should be having this conversation with you.
Yeah.
You're leaving now.
Let me say goodbye.
I said now. When you're called, you drop everything. A skull above any other.
A skull above any other.
Please join the others in the center of the room.
Hey, guys.
Silence!
He yelled at me, too. I'm Brian, by the way.
Gentlemen, kneel down before us. It's time to go down the rabbit hole, gentlemen. If you're ready.
I'm Nathan Lloyd, class of 1975. On behalf of the Order of the Skulls, I welcome you. But before we can trust you with our secrets, you must first show your trust in us.
Each of you will drink from the glass that has been placed in front of you. With this drink, you will die. Your soul will be cleansed, and you will be reborn.
Faith, gentlemen. Give us yours, and you will forever have ours.
Shed the last symbols of your old life. Remove your clothes.
Stand up! Hesitate and you'll never see this place again.
All right, boys. You heard the man. No time to be shy.
Now or never, guys.
All been found worthy and have accepted our invitation. You all come from different backgrounds, but you will all be equal in our order. This is just the beginning of what we call the revealing process. Over the next 14 days, you will undergo a series of trials to prove your worthiness. Prepare to be tested.
Sleep tight.
Everybody all right? Here's something. Look at this.
We got a note.
Let's check it out. Some kind of timer. To say, you have all now been reborn. This is your first step toward becoming members of the society.
Yeah!
Your next step was to find your way home. Do so before time runs out, or your journey will end here. You must come as one, or do not come at all.
Where the hell are we, anyway?
Okay, we need to find ourselves a road or a river or something like that. Something we can follow to guide us. What do you say?
Yeah. All right, let's go.
Wait, Taylor. Where's Taylor?
Taylor.
She's not here.
Good. Maybe they had her cremated.
Hey. Geniuses, don't you get it? We're supposed to do everything together as a team. This must be part of the test. Now, help me find her. You two check back there. The rest of you spread out. Circle around from the backside one more time.
Okay.
Okay. Calm down, Taylor. This is just a test. think. Yeah. You can do this.
Okay?
Yeah. You?
Yeah.
Where's everybody else?
They're waiting for us. Here, put this on.
Thanks.
Just get the hell out of here.
You know we're gonna end up babysitting her.
Oh, who cares? Jeez. It's not like she stands a chance of surviving the revealing process anyway.
I really wish you guys would stop talking about me behind my back. Hey, don't worry about it. Anybody know what's next?
Well, we've got 20 minutes to get back to the tomb, and the problem is, we don't know where we are.
Sure we do. This is East Rock Park.
No, actually, we're on the other side of town. This is West Rock Park.
How do you know that?
Different trees. Plus, I don't hear a river, and East Rock has a river.
Different trees?
She's a botanist.
I run here all the time. If I'm right, there's a cemetery about a quarter mile down that way. These woods run all the way into the city. They connect with Edgewood Park.
Which leads us right back to campus.
Yeah. Let's go.
We're gonna listen to her?
No, let's go.
Come on, hustle. Let's go.
Glad to see you found your way. All of you.
Don't sound so disappointed, Roger. Chose you because we expect you to succeed. We expect you to pass every test. And as my son said, all of you. Please, join us inside.
Let's get in there. All right, let's go.
Okay. I just wanted to say I was really impressed back there.
Thanks. You're the only one who seems willing to give me a chance.
The other guys will come around.
Oh, I'm not so sure about that.
You're gonna make them come around.
That's some pretty sick shit. Them burying you alive like that. I mean, somebody could get hurt.
That's the point. They want to test your loyalties. Make sure you understand.
Understand what?
That they were in control of your lives now? Is that what you were going to say?
Something like that. They make you give them control.
Take your mark.
They demand your trust. For those 2 weeks, you don't have a choice. But they also make sure to show you what kind of rewards are waiting. Of course, not all the rewards were equal.
Hey, you already up?
The problem is you said
I never got to sleep.
Oh, secret skulls activities? Details.
Come on, V. You know I can't talk about that.
Well, I hope whatever they put you through wasn't half as bad as what we did to our girls.
I'm sure it was horrible.
You have no idea. Anyways, I'm gonna get some coffee. Don't forget you gotta meet your dad for breakfast this morning.
Oh, no.
Morning, Dad.
You're late.
Sorry. We were out all night.
Is that supposed to be an excuse?
I thought you'd understand. I mean, you know how hard this is. When we talked last week...
That was before the general membership started calling me at all hours of the night.
Well, don't worry, Dad. I don't expect you to defend me. In fact, I don't expect anything from you.
Don't make me out to be the bad guy. I admire your initiative, Taylor. But this isn't the local country club we're talking about. Our rules have always superseded those of the outside world. And there are a lot of very powerful men do not want to see those rules challenged or changed.
Wasn't it you that taught me never to back down from a challenge?
You listen to me, young lady. You're just lucky that Nathan Lloyd is head of the council. He's the one that told Dean Lawton to go ahead and tap you, and only as a courtesy to me.
Well, I don't really care who made the decision, Dad, or why. I'm the one who chose to do this. And I'll do it with or without your support. I just assumed I'd have it.
Taylor.
I'm gonna go get some sleep before I say something we both regret.
Sit down, Miss Brooks. You can go home when I tell you to.
I need a break. Look, you've got to keep going, Taylor. You gotta help me here.
Yeah, come on, Taylor. Help us out here. Because right now, I got a kid downstairs with his head bashed in, and we'd like to know how that happened, so maybe you can get to that part, huh?
You've got to understand how it was. It's what you want, isn't it?
Of course it is. Listen, it sounds like you're under a lot of pressure. Having just gone through initiation, your relationship shaky, your dad not supporting you, it must have been hard.
I was handling it.
Hey, Taylor. Right. Taylor.
Hey.
It's been a crazy couple of weeks, huh?
It's one way to put it. I can barely stay awake in class.
Well, I stopped trying. This morning I passed out in Latin American fiction.
Who do you have, Cooper?
Uh-huh, Mr. Excitement. I think he took it personally.
At least he got some rest.
Hey, you want to grab a coffee?
Only if it's a really big cup.
I'm kind of like you in a way. I wasn't supposed to get tapped by the skulls.
What do you mean?
Well, let's call it a conspicuous lack of breeding, at least by the skull's lofty standards. A lower middle class family raised by my mom. Don't ask about my dad, because I don't know.
I'm sorry.
Nah, my mom was great. I'm not ashamed of where I came from, not at all. It's just, it's just a little different for the skulls. Nathan Lloyd kind of helped me along.
Seriously?
Yeah, my mom works for his company. I interned in his office last summer.
Wow. You must have impressed him.
Yeah, I don't know. I got the impression that Roger and he didn't really have the best relationship, you know? Anyways, I've never had anyone like a father figure looking out for me. It's kind of cool. And what about you? After everything you've been through, is it still worth it?
I don't know yet. I started this to prove something to my father. Guess we're all looking for that approval. But now I think I'm trying to prove it to myself.
Yeah, I know what you mean. So how's Ethan? I mean, you two are together, right?
I'm not sure anymore. He's pretty angry, and I can't blame him.
It's too bad.
Well, when this is over, we'll see what happens. Thank you.
Right now, I'm more concerned about tonight.
Should be an adventure, whatever it is.
You've all come a long way in the last 2 weeks. Here it is, gentlemen. Your final test.
A key to the tomb has been lost, swallowed by the great blue serpent and hidden within its bowels. Look for the sign which impales its back and you will find the key, but it will take all of you to lift it.
What the hell does that mean?
A riddle.
Actually, it's pretty easy.
Oh, well, please do enlighten us. Bingo. River's the blue serpent. The buoy impales the river.
And the key is in its bowels.
So this thing's underwater?
Come on, check it out. Come on.
Levers.
Plus, someone needs to go in and retrieve the key.
I'll do it, if you'll pull me out.
Deal. Let's get the guys.
Key. Where's Taylor? Taylor! I gotta go back down and get it.
We'd have to go back down.
She got it! She got the key!
Press it, Taylor.
Congratulations, gentlemen. And to you, Miss Brooks. This is the end of the revealing process. You will now receive your own key to this tomb. You will also receive a rule book. Study it. It is a key to a successful and rewarding life within our order.
We live by the rules.
We die by the rules. Trust no one with these secrets but a member of the Order. Tell no one what you see and hear within these walls. No outsider shall ever know the work of the Order or the composition of our membership. Always remember, a skull above any other. Now, if you will all present your left wrist, there is one final ordeal. The pain you're about to feel is temporary, but the mark is forever, and you will bear it as has every skull before you, and as will every skull to come. Be silent as you endure.
Something wrong?
No. I'm here to deliver this, and I wanted to see how you were doing.
Well, it's still sore, but it'll be all right.
Listen, Taylor, when you told me what you were doing, I misunderstood. Nathan Lloyd says you handled the revealing process admirably.
And you're surprised.
I know I shouldn't be. Taylor, I don't know when or why I turned away from you. I certainly never meant to. Sam's death just...
I know.
Dad... There were things I didn't want to admit. I pushed him to do something he didn't want to do. To be something that he wasn't. And when I found out what you were trying to do, it brought everything back. It made me look at some things that I did not want to see. I have been so unfair to you.
Dad.
I want to fix that. Start again.
Well, I'd like that too.
Besides, if anyone's daughter is going to be the first woman in the skulls, it better be mine. This is for you. I'll see you tonight.
Tonight? What's tonight?
Well, I guess I just have to show up and find out.
This was yesterday.
So why don't you just tell us what happened? I mean, what the hell is this all about?
Taylor. I think I should talk to my father.
Excuse me?
From this point on, it gets confusing. I just need to see him.
Taylor, we've got to know what happened. You can tell us.
But I can't. Not exactly.
Bullshit, you can. You won't. Either you killed this kid.
No.
Or you know who did. Either way, it comes back to you.
It's not true. It's not true.
Then what is true?
I don't know.
I think you do know, but we can't help you unless you tell us what's going on.
God damn it, I am sick of this little dance, Miss Brooks. We know he didn't die in the alley. We also know that his body was placed there to make it look like a mugging. You were with him last night, weren't you?
No.
Weren't you?
No, please.
Wrap it up, guys.
What are you talking about, Captain?
These gentlemen represent Miss Brooks, and since we have no reason to hold her...
No reason?
That's right, Detective. Thank you for your cooperation, Miss Brooks. You're free to leave.
Who called the lawyers?
Does it matter?
God damn it.
Taylor! Hey! Sorry it took so long. I trust you didn't reveal too much.
About the skulls, you mean?
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Hey, come on. I'll give you a lift.
No. Thanks.
I gather your father's pretty distraught. It's understandable, isn't it?
Dad? Dad?
Sweetheart.
Dad? You have to believe I had nothing to do with this.
I do. Of course I do. But what did happen?
I'm still not sure. After you dropped off the invitation yesterday, we were all taken to Nathan Lloyd's estate. Wow. This place is fantastic.
Gentlemen, if you'll head inside, the staff will get you settled.
Miss Brooks, we have other accommodations for you.
Follow me.
I hope you don't mind staying out here by yourself.
This really isn't necessary.
Yes, well,
yeah, actually, it is. I figure you spent the last 2 weeks proving that you could compete in our male world. The least we can do is show you that we still know how to treat a lady. Now, the boys are sharing rooms in the main house, and we just wanted to offer you a little privacy.
Well, thank you.
So I've got some work to take care of up at the house.
The government bid? Is there anything I could do to help?
No, thanks. I've got somebody on it. But you could make sure that the caterer gets his check this time. I'd appreciate that.
Of course.
See you later.
The reception starts in 1 hour. I'll see you then.
Formal. Ethan.
I'm over here.
Ethan, what are you doing here?
I got your message.
What are you talking about?
Your email? You told me to meet you here.
Taylor, are you out here?
There's a coach house out front. Wait for me, but stay out of sight. I'll be there as soon as I can.
What are you doing out here?
Just getting some fresh air. Is that a problem?
My father wanted to see you inside.
Out, it shines on you. It's not a secret now, no more than it was the day I met you. The day I met you.
Ethan?
I'm right here. What's going on?
You tell me. I can't believe you come here like this.
Hey, you're the one who asked me, remember? What is this, some bullshit skulls prank? Invite Ethan here and rub his face in it?
No. I never sent any.
What's wrong?
I don't know. I don't feel too good.
Great. You have too much to drink?
No.
Come on. You need to lie down. I'll help you.
Ethan? 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 Ethan! This isn't funny. Where are you?
Who are you looking for?
What's going on, Taylor? Someone else here?
No. Yes. It's Ethan. He was here last night.
I can't believe this. You brought him here? This is supposed to be a private event. God damn it, Taylor. It's sacred.
I didn't invite him. He just showed up.
Yeah, well, I guess you didn't make him leave either. Where is he?
I'm not sure. There was blood.
What? Where?
In the coach house, on the door.
You okay?
I don't know what happened. I can't remember anything from last night. My head is pounding. I don't know.
What is it?
Ethan?
No, don't touch him.
Oh, my God. We have to call 911. We have to do something.
No, it's too late.
Take her to the house.
Clearly the Rawlings boy must have come on too strong. Taylor, I'm sure, was just merely defending herself.
Is that what it was? Was it self-defense?
No, it wasn't self-defense. I didn't do this.
It's the only thing that makes sense.
Because if it was self-defense, then we can go to the police.
Of course. Of course, the other side is, it'd be very difficult to prove. And Martin, you're looking at a run for the Senate. The press will be all over this thing before Taylor could even put up a defense.
How can we make this go away?
This is why we belong to the Order. I can have this taken care of, if that's what you want.
Yes. That's what I want.
No. No. I didn't do this. I didn't do this. Don't you understand? We have to find out who did.
Taylor, you don't even remember. We have to protect you. We have to protect ourselves.
Take her home. I'll handle it.
After you took me home this morning, didn't take long before the detective showed up. I wanted to tell them everything. I started to, but when it came time to talk about last night, I couldn't do it. Then the lawyers were there, and Roger Lloyd. What is it?
Nathan called.
When?
About 20 minutes ago, just before you got home. I saw the news coverage, finding his body in an alley. You're sure there's no way the police can connect this with her?
No, there's nothing to worry about.
She says she didn't do it, Nathan, and I believe her. Isn't there some way that we can...
Think about it, Martin. There was no forced entry. You saw how hungover she was this morning, and she can't even remember what happened. And the blood.
I know.
I'm gonna go all the way on this for you and your daughter, Martin.
but I need something in return.
What is it?
My company has submitted a bid under seal to Congress. It's being considered by the Military Procurement Subcommittee, the committee that you chair.
Nathan, we've been through this.
Martin, you know that I deserve to be the sole provider of cellular and wireless technology to the military.
How can you take advantage of this situation?
You owe me at least this much, Congressman. A skull above any other, remember that? Because you seem to have forgotten it last month when I first submitted this bid.
We can just blindly support each other and ignore the potential consequences.
Isn't that exactly what I've been doing? One way or another, your daughter is responsible for this mess. And I have taken care of it for you. Now, can I count on your support when I need it?
You'll have my support.
How much is the contract worth?
Billions. Billions.
Dad. Don't you see? This is all a setup. They want you to think I'm guilty so that you'll cooperate. We have to go back to the police.
Tell them what? Don't you see? Whether or not you did this doesn't matter. All that matters is they can sure as hell make it look as if you did, and your life will be ruined, and so will mine.
What are we gonna do then? Just let them get away with it?
I don't know, Taylor. I don't know. For now, just go back to school. Go back to swimming. We will carry on with our normal routines. We will put this behind us. I have to fly out tonight. There's a vote in Washington. Taylor, let the Skulls handle this. It is the only way.
NCAA testing. Hey, Taylor.
Yeah?
Come into my office when you're done. Hi. Come on in. Have a seat.
What's going on?
This is Dr. Franks from the NCAA. She's in charge of drug testing.
Yeah, we met.
We know you're dealing with a personal tragedy. Frankly, I was surprised to see you today.
Sometimes swimming's the best way for me to deal with stress.
Have you taken anything? Xanax, Valium, some kind of sedative you didn't report on the questionnaire? You know, maybe help you sleep.
No, I haven't taken anything. I'm not lying. Why would I?
That's the thing, Taylor. We believe you.
Sometimes with female athletes, we find something that raises a flag. You had traces of a drug class known as benzodiazepine in your system. Now, if it's not from medication, then this particular drug signature, it could be indicative of Rohypnol.
That's a date rape drug, Taylor.
I appreciate the concern, but nothing like that happened.
There's been no time over the last few days where you went out drinking, woke up disoriented, couldn't remember the previous night, anything like that?
No.
Do you need to take some time off?
Sure. Maybe a couple days.
Taylor, you have to speak out to protect yourself. You don't have to be a victim.
Yeah, thanks.
We are gathered here today to mourn the passing and to celebrate the life of Ethan Rawlins.
I never noticed.
I'm sure many of you must
be. I never saw any cracks on the window. I never saw myself as sentimental. Without you, I've been
That was a lovely service, wasn't it? Look, if there's anything you need, we're here for you.
I'd just like to be left alone.
Don't make us your enemy, Taylor.
Is that a threat, Roger?
It's a strong suggestion.
Well, I have a suggestion for you. Stay the hell away from me.
Look, you want to find out what we can really do? Keep pushing. You want a threat? Try this. We have the dress and the murder weapon. That's right. The glass sculpture from the coach house. And guess what, Taylor? It has your fingerprints all over it. So unless you want the police to find it, you better step your ass back in line. You're either with us or you're against us. There is no middle ground.
Hey. Is everything okay?
Everything's fine.
I thought you might need a ride home.
Thank you. I just want you to know how much I appreciate. I mean, everything that's happened.
You don't have to say anything. I'm glad I could be here.
Brian?
You.
Oh my God. They've been watching me all this time.
Taylor.
They set me up. This picture at the track with Ethan, that was before we were even tapped. They knew we was at the party. How could they know?
They probably have pictures of all of us.
How can you make excuses for them? They drugged me, Brian. Ethan's dead, and they're threatening to pin it on me unless my father gives Lloyd what he wants. These pictures are just to make sure I get the point.
Look, I'm not making excuses. It's just if you challenge them...
You can't just walk through life and pretend this never happened.
It's better than spending the rest of your life in jail.
I don't see any difference. I don't know, but I'm pretty sure I know who sent him.
I can't believe Nathan Lloyd's involved in this. Taylor, who's this?
Oh, no. Let's go. Veronica! Veronica? Something we need to talk about.
I'll get the kettle.
Poor Ethan. I can't believe this. Listen, V, starting tomorrow, you should go stay with someone else for a while. Just in case, you know?
I don't see anyone out front.
You think I might be in danger?
think everyone around me is in danger.
What are you gonna do?
I need to find some kind of proof that Roger and his father are behind all this. I don't even know where to start.
Well, what about the email?
What about it?
Ethan told you you got an email, didn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, but I never sent anything.
Well, somebody did. I mean, obviously, whoever took these pictures knew who's gonna be at the party, right? And they must have accessed your student email account to make it look authentic.
I'm not sure how this helps.
Well, if they used your campus account, we must be able to access the message from the university server.
It's worth a try.
The library terminals are connected directly to the campus server. Lucky for you, not lucky for me. I used to go with the guy who worked in the computer services office. Anyway, it's good for a free dinner now and then, and things like the university server's password. Okay, here we go. All emails sent using your account, no matter what computer it was sent from.
There, that's the day of the party. It's addressed to Ethan. Dear Ethan, so sorry for the last 2 weeks. We really need to talk. I can't deal with the pressure from the skulls anymore. Please meet me tonight at the Lloyd Estate. Wait for me at the back patio and be careful not to let anyone see you.
So Ethan thought it was really from you.
But who sent it? We don't know who, but we know the address of your computer.
What do you mean by address?
Well, every computer has a unique address embedded into every outgoing email. It's called an internet protocol address. So all you have to do is find the computer that matches this number, and you'll find out who sent you the email. Here, I'll write it down for you.
You're a genius, V.
Yeah, imagine that. Sorority girl with a brain. But the one thing I can't tell you is where to find that computer.
We'll have to wait until the morning, but I have a pretty good idea where to start looking. But first, we have to stop Lloyd from getting what he wants.
Taylor, the vote is in an hour. I've already called in every favor I could to make sure that Lloyd's company does get the contract.
Dad, if we don't stop them now, neither one of us will ever be free.
Honey, I don't care about myself anymore. All I care about is you, your future.
Don't worry about that. I'm gonna find the truth. Somehow. Look, if this hadn't happened, would you be giving Lloyd this contract?
No, I wouldn't.
Why not?
Last month, we lost an aircraft. It was outfitted with communications equipment from Lloyd's company. There was no solid evidence, but there was speculation that his components conflicted with the guidance system and caused the plane to crash.
Dad, if you give him this now, what will he ask for next time? Just make the right vote. I'll deal with the consequences. And just to be safe, we're staying at the house tonight.
Taylor?
I'll talk to you later.
It appears that Martin Brooks and his daughter have decided to challenge us.
Gentlemen.
Evening, Martin.
Slight change of plans.
It's time to give the police what they're looking for.
Happened.
What do you want to do?
We have to get out of here. If they take me in now, I'll never get to the truth. Veronica, stall him as long as you can. Who is it?
Police, open up.
Hang on, I'm not dressed.
Taylor Brooks?
Oh, I haven't seen her since last night.
And you are?
I'm Veronica Bell. I'm a roommate.
Well, Veronica Bell, do you make a habit of staying at her father's house without her?
Oh, he's out of town, so, you know, I help out with various things and whatnot.
Valdez!
Looks like we just missed her. But our phone call's legit.
Any idea why your roommate would be hiding this in her closet, Miss Bell?
Slow down! Kayla, hey! You just ran away from the police. You're a fugitive now.
I know. I'm sorry for getting you into this. If you want to leave, I'll understand.
I'm in way too deep to walk away now.
Thank you. Let's go find that computer.
We need to distract her somehow.
I won't let anything happen to it. Just get here as fast as you can, okay?
We have to get the computer.
I'll get it.
Be careful.
Brian, what are you doing?
Let's go. Oh no, it's Lloyd.
It's hiding here. We don't even know if we have the right computer.
We will in a minute. Anyway, it doesn't matter. We're running out of time.
I think we should wait. Don't answer that.
Brian, I just pulled in. Where are you? Brian?
That was Nathan Lloyd. And how did you know about the key? You're helping Lloyd. You brought me here on purpose.
Brian, what happened? You were supposed to get her here without any major incident, and I find Roger on the dining room floor
and my security man spitting his teeth into a sink.
Well, Roger got here first. He was taking
I see. Well, none of that will matter now.
What are you going to do? Kill me?
No. You're going to kill yourself. Tragically, in the same place where you killed your boyfriend.
How could you do this? You planned this from the beginning. It was all about getting to my father, wasn't it?
You forgot the first rule. A skull above any other. And when he rejected my initial bid, I couldn't believe the delicious irony of having his daughter challenging us for a place. You and your father brought this on yourselves.
Why Ethan? He didn't have anything to do with this.
He was convenient?
Who did this? I want to know, was it you, Brian? Was that your price? Did you kill Ethan to get into the skulls?
Actually, when it comes to important matters, I prefer not to delegate. Brian didn't have any idea what he was getting himself into. Oh.
Oh my God. No! Help me! Brian! Brian!
But Brian's a good and loyal associate, and I appreciate that. He's willing to do whatever is necessary.
Unlike your son? That's what you wanted to say, isn't it? You couldn't get me to go along with setting up Taylor's father, so you asked Brian to do it?
Roger, I told you to stay back at the house.
Yeah, well, I'm through listening to you. I'm sorry, Taylor. I didn't know. But we're getting the hell out of here. I already called the police. They're on their way right now.
The police will believe what I tell them to believe.
Actually, you've already told them quite a bit. Here, catch.
She dialed 911.
You stupid bitch. Do you know who I am? Do you think I can't walk right out of this?
No, you can't.
Mr. Lloyd, we have to get out of here.
No, you stay put, Brian. We're gonna walk away from this, trust me.
Go ahead, Taylor. Come on, go. I'm not gonna let you get away with this, Dad.
Brian, come back here!
Hold it! Hands on your head, walk towards me.
Oh, my God. Roger.
Freeze! Detective, please, you have to listen to me.
Step aside, Taylor.
Get behind the car.
Put the gun down, Mr. Lloyd.
There's no need for you people. This is an internal matter, and I have it perfectly under control.
We can discuss this later, Mr. Lloyd. I want you to drop the gun right now.
Oh, fine. Then I'll just call your supervisors. Taylor, come back inside. Come on.
Drop the gun! How dare you let me! Hold your fire!
Hold your fire!
You all right, Miss Brooks?
It was all Lloyd. He killed Ethan.
I know, Roger called us. We were already on our way over. He's the one who filled us in.
is dead.
Dispatch, this is Stainer Valdez. Gonna need an ambulance, a phone, a wagon. Enjoy the state. 53 Maple Grove. Shots fired. Send me a forensics team.
That's important. It's all the way.
Get in the car, kid.
Taylor, someone to see you. Thank you for what you did.
I don't deserve any thanks. I came to apologize.
I'll leave you two alone.
Taylor?
It wasn't your fault, Roger. I know that now. You did the right thing in the end. If it wasn't for you...
I can't believe I've waited my entire life to become a skull, just to please my father. I never wanted to believe he could be involved in something like this, but I guess I always knew. And then he gave the murder weapon to the police, and when I overheard him call Brian about the email, that's why I took the computer. I knew he would destroy it.
Brian. I still can't believe it. I completely trusted him. I guess he'll spend the rest of his life in jail.
For what? The skulls? I also want you to know, I actually admire the way you fought your way in. And especially the way you fought your way out. I could never tell you that before. Too busy trying to play the part my father expected.
I kind of know how that works.
Is there any chance we might end up being friends?
Are you still a skull? Then I'd say we're off to a pretty good start. How are you doing anyway?
I'm good. I'm good.
Do you want to stay a while? I'm sure we have a lot to talk about.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Come on over. How's your arm?
So goes the best of us dreamers. I got a map, got a road without any signals. Make them as you go. Some never know what a storm's like until you're in it. Some only stare from a window. I wanna feel what it's like when I stand in the rain.
got a map, got a road without any signals. Make 'em as you go.